Okay, hey, welcome back. Just take a look at this plane, and it is a really cool model. Designing it does take a lot of effort. Really, you got to pay attention to the directions. But there it is. I've got it in shaded and hidden line mode. Very, very cool. So it's going to be a challenge to create it. So let's jump on in and try this. So let me open up another tab here and get started. So here it is. This is the actual picture. So you can tell there's a lot of text, a lot of reading. And so look at the diagrams, and it really helps on how to set this up. So I noticed right here in this little picture here, it says to select the surface option, right? And then from there, we're going to sketch this figure 37. Starting with the top plane. So let's do that. So I go here, I go to surface, and then I go to sketch. It says to select the top plane, which is this here, I think. Yep. And then we're going to draw that shape. And it's the ellipse tool. So over here, you go to the left button here, drop that down, find the word ellipse. And the way that works is you select the origin there on the top, okay? Click. You're gonna drag over to the right here, and the value is 75. So type in 75, and then tab on the keyboard, and I'm gonna click. Make sure I'm horizontal, and then once I click, I'm able to adjust this dimension, which is 20. Tab again and enter. So these values, 75 is the larger value. That's called the major axis. And you learn that in geometry. And then the smaller value here, 20, is called the minor axis. So those are the values of this ellipse. Take a look at the diagram here. It's been trimmed. And that's what it says here in the direction, says trim tool. So you've got to trim everything off so that you're left with just this quarter section. Alrighty. And I'm going to my trim tool. And I should be able to trim. Let's see. Nope, I can't trim. Now here's why I can't trim. I can't trim because you need a construction line to create intersection points. So I'm going to head on over to, the diagram here, click on line, X on the keyboard to draw my construction line. So I'll start here, go here. Now if you try to trim, it might not work because these construction lines escape on the keyboard. They still float, you see that? They're not attached. Same thing with this one here. You want them to be constrained to the origin. So how do you constrain it? Use the coincident tool. Okay, the horizontal is already selected. Select the origin. Select this vertical. And there you go. Totally constrained. Now when I go to the trim tool, I'm able to trim those sections. All right, perfect. It's okay, this is blue. That's perfectly fine. If you were to constrain, like escape, if I was to grab this tool, there is a way to constrain it. You can take this point here and anchor it so that it doesn't move. You can constrain this, but according to this set of directions, it's not. And so I'm gonna leave it unconstrained for now. Alrighty, and so now you've finished the sketch. And your next option is to revolve it. And I went to front, I need to go to top. So I want to revolve this. And the way I revolve it is you go to the revolve tool from the create option. And there it is. That's the tool. Mm-hmm. So let's click on here. And these are surfaces. They're not closed shapes. Select this here, Okay. And look at the set of directions again. Select the shape and revolve it. Okay, so that's select that blue section. I just did. Everything looks fine. The axis that you're going to select is this one here. And there you go. See everything as is. New body. Yep, perfect. That's what you have. All right. So, okay, I'm going to zoom in. And there's the nose cone for our plane. All right, so the next step here is to take this curve, which is revolved, create another sketch, and then project this edge so that we can extrude it. Because remember, these aren't solids, these are surfaces. So here it says start a new sketch and project around the edge of nose on right plane as shown in figure 40, exit the sketching environment. So this is what we're looking at. So that method of taking that edge is we're going to kind of rotate. So I'm shifting and I'm using my mouse wheel, rotating just a hair. See that edge right there? You can't use that for anything yet unless you project it. Now turn that blue line purple, watch. So you go to sketch, right? Select this plane right there, and that's the, I think they call it the X, what is it? X, Z, or no, the YZ plane. Is that the terminology they use? Let me double check here. Did they use the YZ plane? They just called it the right plane. So there it is right there, the right plane. It's perfectly aligned with that edge. Now, create, and there it is. Project, include, project. Get this whole new window right in here, see it? You're going to take that and select selection filter. Click right on that edge. And it says it's selected. Okay. Let's see what else does it show. I think everything's okay. Choose okay. And now you notice if I rotate just slightly, it's got that purple hue. You see it? I don't know if it shows up in the video. I can see it. But it has that purple hue. You finish the sketch. And now that edge is going to be accessible. Go to the extrude option, which is the next step. And then you're going to take this object and extrude it out 100. And I think it's 25 units. Let's see. What does it show? No, it says click in the distance, edit box, and enter the value 90. Okay. So again, I'm looking at this information. It says to select this here. Already did. It says move this 90. So I'll type the number 90. It's faster. And everything else you leave as is. After the parameters are selected, you choose OK, which is the same thing as enter, and you're looking great. Now, there it is. Now you notice you can see all these edges, right? It's because I'm on the mode, the display mode that says visual style shaded with hidden edges. Okay, and you can go shaded with visible edges. You'll see the same kind of, almost the same kind of thing, just the visible portion. I don't mind seeing the hidden edges. Change that back. All right, great. Now, according to the directions, again, there's a lot of reading going on. I just read this little information here. It says 90. I'm going to go to click on the offset plane tool of construction drop-down toolbar. The offset plane, again, is the same YZ plane or the right plane shown in figure 42. And then you're going to create a distance of 125. Okay. If you do that, click OK. So I can do that. And so the offset plane is under the construction tool. Offset plane. Again, I'm picking this plane right there. And then I'm going to offset that 125. And there it is. Okay, enter is sending, saying OK. I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to try to enlarge it too. Just drag it out just a hair. There we go. I like that. So far, so good. Then it says to start a new sketch on this newly created plane. Click on the center, the diameter circle. They create a circle shown in figure 43, which is there. So I'm going to draw a circle right there. Yeah, okay. So it sounds like we're drawing something on the backside. And let's do it. Pacing 4. Mm-hmm. It doesn't look like it's constrained at all either. So I'm going to kind of position it and high it. So let's go here. I'm going to create a circle. Let's click on this plane right there. See it? It's activated. And diameter tool. It's this one here. Now you notice that I don't see the markings that I saw here. See the red and the green? So that just means that my origin is hidden. So I click on that origin folder. Shows up. Now I can see it. See that? So there, you can project now. See it? So I'm going to project upward. And create a circle right here and draw it 4 units. It's good. Enter. And there you have it. Now, see, this circle, it floats. See it? So I should try to probably constrain it so that it's totally centered. And I am. So I'm going to constrain it there. So I'll go to the coincident tool, click on this screen, click on the point. And escape the keyboard. Now it's totally constrained vertically. See that? Doesn't move left and right. I didn't constrain it on the origin, otherwise I wouldn't be able to move. But I'll put it about right. Looks like the diagram has it. Let's take a look. Yeah, a little above the halfway point. Okay, so let's do that. About right there. That looks good. Okay, finish the sketch. So now I have this floating spot, okay? So what do I do with that? Well, according to the directions, I think we're going to use the loft tool, okay? So now after creating the sketch, you just choose to finish and click on the loft tool. And then you need to select the 2 sketches. And they've got, if you look closer here, it's hard to see. But we're going to choose the first circle, larger one, than the smaller circle, second one, profile 1, profile 2. First circle has, profile 1 has a tangent setting, and profile 2 has a connect setting. And yeah, it's going to make a difference here. So let's give that a shot. Then we choose OK. So tangent and connect. So loft tool. There it is. Select this. Oh, so that messed up. So let me just close that out. Close that out. And let's do it again. This is first. And this is that. Now, we're going to change this here to tangent. And there you go. See how it rounded it? And then this one here is connected. And everything else I think is the same. I didn't see anything that said select the check marks. Let's see. We need the check mark. Chain, no, I don't see any of that. So I'm going to leave it as is. Perfect. Looks good. Leave everything the same. It's a new body. Choose OK. All right. Now, so now we have kind of the fuselage of our plane. It's kind of like a banana, huh? Anyway, there it is. So that's a good start. I'm going to poke the eye of the origin. I'm going to stop there. This will be part one of creating our toy aircraft. Hope that starts you off in a strong position. Like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. See you soon. Bye-bye.